We go for one of the next topics, which is basically just a short presentation on how you may enrich your instrument file with some further code than what is in the instruments. Under the label of advanced language features one. I guess some of you probably already talked to Mass about some of these features, but now we'll come back to what they are, more formally speaking. So you probably, in your instrument file, you noticed that you have a section called declare and one called initialize. And this basically allows you to do freeform C code in here. So if you have, if you want, say, the reason to have this one, it has a lot of flags, right? If you want to define a flag or a neutral parameter of some sort, you may do so here. So in here, I define something called my var here, and maybe my variable here is then some function of another, maybe an input parameter here, so that's square root of pi times the value of the input parameter, and then I add a random number here. So this is just to illustrate that you can basically do anything. Anything you can formulate in a mathematical function, you can use to parameterize your instrument of all the parameters of subsequent components. So both of these use normal C syntax. So kerning and enriching here, we're not really kerning and enriching, maybe we are more GNU-ish. We're kind of a GNU-ish C. So generally speaking, GCC, that's our production compiler. So this may be trivial to some. So you've seen that for the rotations, our angles are in degrees, right? So when you write the hat and rotate the keyboard, angles are in degrees. But in here, math.h, trigonometry functions, of course, are in radians, right? So remember that little thing, it's just a little thing. So you'll need the dead to red and these kinds of macros that are available in the math library. Yes, then what can be used also in declare, which I think we will not actually demonstrate as such in the course, that is what is called include here. So if you are, maybe your instrument file becomes sufficiently complicated that you would like to segment it in pieces. So maybe you want your primary spectrometer in one file and you want the secondary spectrometer in another file. And there's a way to do that. One example is that, so that's a triple axis at the ILL, the IL22 in the guide hole. This includes first a description of the guide, which it reads from this file, and then it includes a triple axis at the end. So this is a way to kind of to segment all your work. And these go typically in the care section. And via a concatenation and our realm becomes a production instrument. So to illustrate how one can use these the features of the CAD initialize, I'll just do a small demo for you. And I've left an instrument file also in GitHub that is kind of what I will probably put together here. So if I take up my GUI here, and then of course I'll do myself a new instrument. Let's call it demo. Let me take it up here. Then, first of all, as you know, we will of course need some neutrons. So let me put in a source. I will put in myself a source. So let's say what I'm aiming at setting up here is a very simple instrument. It has a source, it has a piece of reflecting mirror, so just a super mirror, and then it has a detector. It's very, very simple. I put in a source here, and I make it a quite small one, because it would be nice that that our beam has kind of ideal properties here. So this source will only be a centimeter in radius. Then it will focus at 10 by 10 centimeters down the beam. Let's make that 4 extra neutrons with a 3.9 extra interval of time. So a white beam, 0 to 8 neutrons. And this I place on my origin. So what I'm also hoping to demonstrate is that maybe I'm making an error as we go along, because you know, making errors, putting these things together is totally normal. That's what we all do until we have something that works. It's a gradual process. So here's the source. What I will then do, you may have seen this already, but what I will do is I will define myself an angle up here. And this angle I will let default to 1 degree. And then what I will do is I will place myself an arm. We've been told that it's good to place arms to define, let's say, points of reference. So I will put an arm in here. And this arm I will rotate omega. Oops, sorry. I'll put it at very, very focus. So that's 10 meters down from the source. And this was called source signal. And then I will rotate it an amount of omega relative not to the previous. It could be, but yeah. I'll use origin here. As a specific label, and this goes here.
Yeah.
Oh, increase the font size.
Okay.
Oh, this works.
Yeah.
Thank you. So it's more visible now. Okay, that's good. So now we have an arm, and then what I will do is I will insert myself a piece of optics. I'll put it in the mirror and leave it as it is. So that is an M equals 2 mirror. So we need to set these are empty. If I try inserting here, it would actually give me, oops, you have to fill something in here. So we need to put in a width and a height here. I'll put in another input parameter. I'll put lem here. This will become a length of the mirror in a second. So I'll put lem for the length of the mirror, and then I'll make it 10 centimeters high. And this one I will actually leave relative to previous, because what will then happen as we change on it? It should then rotate together with the arm. So that's the idea of the arm. So for the reactor people, you can think of arms as reference points for your rotations or motors, basically. So in a triple axis, you would have two arms on one main position, you would have two arms at the center position, and you would have two arms for your analyzer. Object orientation and true theta. So I put this in. Good. And then I define a lem here. Let's make a lem default of 20 centimeters. So this is then good. And then to demonstrate that we can have some code here that has a meaning. This example is kind of simple, but maybe we can easily come up with something more complicated to do. But in principle, how about defining two theta? That's a very simple expression, of course, but defining two theta based on the omega. So let myself define double. So this is now C syntax, and this is why I have to declare the type. So I put a double here, which is called 2 theta, like that, n by a semicolon, because it's C syntax. And then what I do in initialize is that I say that the meaning of 2GM is simply 2 times over there. So that's extremely simple. Right? That's extremely simple. So what I will then use that for is I will go further down. And by the way, this editor, as you see, it's possible to write directly in this. So what I will do is I will put an arm here, which is just the same as this one. I have to give it another name. And then I will rotate it by 2 theta. Like that. So this means that now we should have both our omega and our 2 theta in the right place. And this means that I can define myself a monitor. I go here and I put in a monitor. Let's just make that a PSD. Anything else? We'll make it a PSD. And I'll make it default 90 by 90 pixels. That's fine. Filing has to get a value. That's my PSD. That defaults to 10 by 10 centimeters. That's fine. Let's use that. And I will put it not 0, 0, 0 relative previous because the arm is actually at the center of rotation, so we need to add a little bit of distance to actually have an arm, if you like. Yeah, a propagation axis. So let's put it about 2 meters. Something like that. So the reason to show you that you can also edit right in here is that most people, once they get accustomed with the syntax of McStas and using a GUI, if they are just a little bit code-oriented already, they might have another editor that they prefer. And this is just a text file. So it means that if you are very good at using Emacs, or you're using Atom, or in Notepad++ on Windows, or whatever you want, you might as well, in the end, edit it this way. So McGUI is really, really nice to put up, let's say, the first version of a file, but once you really have more or less what you want to do the advanced things, you might want to move to your favorite editor. Okay, so that is now my file. I will save that, and then I will press run. So this actually compiles, and what we'll do as a start is that we'll have a look that it looks reasonable, and 1 degree of rotation will be hard to see. So let's make it 45 degrees, so that will take up 190 degrees. That should be easy to see. What is also accessible here, that's a lot of different ways of visualizing the output. So you already saw this WebGL, which is a three-dimensional thing. For this, I would actually prefer to take something simpler. So I take the one which is IQC graph here. So that is simply three planes instead. And if I did my work right, it's coming here. So what you get here is, and maybe that's actually, it's actually time to do this. Is that better? It's not really good. If better. So what you have is a long beam here and up there, so that's a side view. This one is an end view. And I already see an error I made. Okay. And this is the top view. So if I take the top view, and then I'm actually able to move it with the mouse. I can move it like this. Some of you that are running an older version of McStas, so the 2.1, will not have this exact way of zooming. I can show you later on what to do instead. But this one, then let's just scroll, and there you have it. So you have one arm here. That's probably a yellow arm, and then a green one there. And I actually made 2 mistakes on me. And what I can see is, what is this red stuff? A way to see that is if I go And then I press H. Unfortunately, that's an underflow. So this, the window flows under. So the information that comes is, there we go. Yeah, it goes underneath. But this gives you a reference here. So origin is cyan, and source symbol is magenta, and the first arm is yellow. The second one is, the red one is the mirror. So my mirror is not at all rotated like I wanted. And also it's put to the side. Okay, so this will get a fix before we do anything else. But then the green one is the second arm, and that at least, so the placement of the detector is right. So this is now rotated to 90 degrees. Okay, so I quit this one and back to the normal colors. So the thing is, this mirror here has an X width and a Y height. Okay? So that means that by default, unless I do something by rotation or whatever, it'll actually be transverse to the beam, it will not be parallel to the beam. So what I will do here maybe I will get out my help. So I go in the component reference. I find my optics and I find my mirror. Where's my mirror? So Mads, could you look up? I think in the website I have a hint that shows how to enable local opening of files, because that's a Safari security thing I need to mess with. Oh. I can't remember what it is. Yeah, sorry about this step to the side here. I think it's from last year. I think it's maybe. But you have the page up.
You want to scroll down? So 2018, and then it says if you search for Safari, no, then it's 2017, I guess. Ah, that's really annoying. Maybe we only have a GitHub issue on that.
Then I'll demonstrate that to you. So I will go on our GitHub, if I bang. And I go for my code and GitHub. CSNS McStas and GitHub. Here it is, issues in GitHub. So here are all the stuff that we didn't fix. What if I say Safari here? Safari. And then it might be that it's not an open book. My dog pages do not open in Safari. C674 workaround. So what it says is that I should go in my advanced. Where's advanced? It says enable the develop menu in Safari. So general. That's on effects, sure. Advanced, show develop menu in the menu bar. I'm sorry about this. So that is there, so now I have a develop, and I should then disable local file restrictions. That's the one. Would you now please work? So that's here. Mirror. Turn on audio also. anyway, I just drag a term up here, and then I do instead, I do my block, mirror. Yes, so that's a mirror. Ah, now it works, that's beautiful. Okay, sorry about this mess, but that's how it is. So one thing which is involved here is that I didn't declare something called center. So center is zero, and that means that the mirror will actually not be centered on the position. It starts at zero and then goes to the positive side. So that is what we were seeing. One of the things we were seeing. Maybe I'll just show you again. So this stuff here, that this guy here is the mirror, and it starts there. It's not centered at all. So what I will need to do is that I will make the mirror centered. Center equals 1. That's one thing. And then we will need a rotation. Does anybody see what the rotation should be? We need to rotate it somehow, to not have it transverse to the beam, but parallel to the beam. So we still have, we have the vertical axis, right? So if we just rotate 90 degrees with respect to the incoming arm, that should be good, right? So if I do 90 degrees there, like that, along the vertical, then I'll still keep my height. So it's just the position. So I hold that, I run ahead, and I trace. I think that looks better. So that looks better? No. That doesn't look better. Why doesn't it look better?
It's my rotation.
I have my rotations mixed?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You see that it's at. Oh.
Ah, that is true. That is true. Yeah. So in fact that's hard to see in this view. Right? But it's certainly possible to see it here. You're completely right. My mirror is 90 meters above. Okay, so this is why this kind of tool is exceptionally valuable. I mean, if you didn't have this, you would have no chance. Right? So, it also demonstrates why it sometimes is a help having someone next to you, because you might not see one digital typing mistake you made.
Okay,
so you are absolutely right. That is amazing. And then I take this one here, and I copy it there, and then this should not be relative to origin for sure, because then we will do another problem. And we have another problem. This will be relative to the previous, and then it shouldn't be omega, but it should be 90 degrees. Now I hope they get it. Like that. We press 1. Let's trace. Yeah. So nothing is at 90 meters, which is healthy. And this looks right. Okay, so this is a super mirror. So I'm now use my space key, or if I not clicking, but at least using the space key here will actually propagate the neutrons one by one, and as this is a super mirror, we have no chance of seeing any reflection at 45 degrees. Right? This is clear. So we have to go back to the low range again. So let's do that. Run. Oops. We run that again. And then I'll introduce another little thing for you that you didn't formally hear about yet, which is a scan. So a scan is a series of experiments, just like at your beamer. So you maybe vary the temperature of the sample environment, and you do a series of measurements, and we do exactly the same. So let's start from 0.5, so half a degree. It's actually taken away from zero, So let's do a scan between 0 and 2 degrees. And then we need to specify a number of steps. So a nice number will be 21. So 21 degree steps. And what we will do, and actually, just to be quick, I'll do something we often don't do. I'll just reduce the number of simulated motions here. And this will make our simulation quite fast. Oh, okay, I made a mistake. So you see, I'm calling MC display here with a scan. Okay, so something comes up. That's probably just the first one. So you can't mix visualization and a scan. So you need to go back to simulation. Then I will press start. And actually, I might as well have my result when it's done. So I just I select MC plot PyQC graph in the second one. This will then also plot what the result of my scan is. So there it goes. Boom. Here we are. So that's better. So something falls off here. That's more obvious here. So maybe good thing would be to remove. Let's remove the effect of the direct beam. So if we don't actually don't scatter, let's take away that neutron. And this I will do, and that's a little bit of cheating. So this is actually in a way one of the next advanced topics, but we'll then cover it a little bit. So I will put a keyword called extend, and then I will put a set of So I actually add a section here that has the same kind of declaration as declare and initialize, starting by curly bracket, percent curly bracket, ending by percent curly bracket. And then what I will say is if not scattered, absorb. And that leads me to discuss another thing, which is so scattered in the samples, for instance, in our sample components, it will actually mean a proper scattering. But everywhere else it just means, yeah, did a calculation occur? Show the line in MC display at this point. That's what it means. In this case, of course, we only scatter the moment we have reflection. So this is what it will express here. If the component mirror calculates that this neutron will be reflected, it will scatter, and otherwise we will end the simulation here. That's what the meaning of absorb is here. That is simply kill this neutron. Okay, so let's...
So the neutron will disappear.
Yeah, so it just stops there. So it means that whatever is in the direct beam and not reflected is now disregarded. So I will press 1. And we should, in fact, if I just press start, we should have another scan. And it will look slightly different. It looks a bit funny. Does anyone have an idea why is it low at the start then?
Because nothing's reaching the mirror.
Yeah. So the footprint of the mirror is 20 centimeters. And it's only rotating just a little bit, and this means that basically very little intensity gets scattered off it. Our beam is 10 by 10 centimeters at that point, so it's just a little bit. So, luckily, what we can do, of course, is that we can put in another instrument parameter. So instead of a 2 meter mirror, let's a 20 centimeter mirror, let's make a nice long one of, I don't know. We have a lot of money on our construction project. We have 5 meters of nice mirror from Swiss Neutronics. And it's probably still about the same effect. Anyway, that's of course because we're going all the way to proper zero, and that should effectively reflect nothing. Right? Okay. Anyway, so you have an idea. Another functionality here on this kind of graph that I can show you is that if you on Windows it will be a control key and then click. On the Mac, the same on Linux, and on the Mac you press the command and click. And then you actually have a nice simulation output. It was actually maybe better than the first version. So you have a nice simulation output as function of what you scanned. So that is simply what is on the PSD as we scan. Yes. Okay, so I have a feeling something is still updated. That is of course this stuff here. That is just the text here, so this can take a minute. So something is still kind of funny, but at least in terms of understanding that you have the full flexibility of putting C in a declare and initialize block to parameterize something which is more simple than a normal number. There's full freedom to do that. Yes? Good. So I think Mass is you are for the next exercise, which is on monochromatics. Yeah, now I've left a copy of this instrument file that I put together on the GitHub.